Oh we going to the gym because we some big back bitches. It's like, nah, let me.
Every second, every minute, man, I swear that she can get it.
All right, 3, 2, 1. Oh, hey, Jada.
You know, Kat, you are the best manager ever. Working hard.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Doing things for us.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate that.
Hey guys, welcome back to another day with K Renee, or should I say another day of me not pushing out content? Because at this point, I'm getting backed up. But anyways, today is Saturday. It's June 1st. For our blessings. We're playing for the correct mindset. And the reason why I say that is because every day or every other day, however you want to put it, we go through things. Like, it's a part of life. Life is literally a period of ups and downs. Like, it's a part of life. We have those ups and we have those downs, and we have those really, really bad downs. The really, really low downs. Like, no, let me stop acting slow. But anyways, when we're going through those downs, we want to make sure that we have the right mindset, make sure that we're getting through these obstacles as sane as we can. I think that's a good way to put it. We want to make sure we're getting through obstacles as sane as we can. We want to make sure that when we come up out of those obstacles and we're going to our highs, we're not so damaged and so, like, destroyed from those lows. So when I pray to God, I literally ask for discernment, I ask for a clear mind, and I ask for the right mind to be able to get through whatever is thrown at me. That should make sense. That makes sense. But I have to run to the store real quick. It's 10:40. My first client is at 12. He's getting a retwist. And then I believe he wants to do barrels. Don't quote me on that. But his birthday coming up, so of course we gotta make sure that boy looking fly. And then my next client, her baby shower is tomorrow. It's actually one of my homegirls. Her baby shower is tomorrow. So after I do him at 12, I'm gonna travel to her and do her hair right after. And then after that, I'm thinking I probably have a couple hours to myself. I kind of want to take some pictures, you know, just for like content reasons and because why not. But I do kind of want to like take some pictures. I don't know, it all depends on how I'm feeling after I get done doing hair. If I go to my homegirl, I'm pretty sure they're gonna have something going on, or some food, or just something going on. But I'm about to go to Walmart, that's a little bit further away from me, real quick, because I've been trying to get a selfie stick and the Targets by me have been sold out. I got like 3 Walmarts by me and 2 Targets by me. Both of the Targets are sold out. One of the Walmart said they only had 2 left, which I don't want to like risk it going out there. But I just want to like head there and then hurry back. I gotta get some shampoo too, because my first client gonna be here at 12. So I just want to go to Walmart, pick up the selfie stick, get some shampoo and conditioner, head back, probably get some food or something and head back. So that's what we doing today. And of course the day gonna leave me where it leave me. And then my son, he is actually with his godmama right now, so I'm just like a free bird. That's me flapping. I'm like a free bird. I don't know if y'all know, but like as a mom, a full-time parent, I'm not even gonna say as a mom, as a full-time parent, when you ain't got your kid, you trying to make plans. What's up, what's on the flow? I mean, my plans is making money today, which is usually what I do. But when you don't have your kid, you just try to like get stuff done, because when you have your child, it's just so much you gotta do, and they always on their feet running around doing this, doing that, mommy this, mommy that, daddy this, daddy that, you know what I mean? So when you have your kid, it's certain things that you not necessarily can't get done, but it'll just be easier because you ain't got your kid.
This is how they get you. So 1 bottle of shampoo, 1 bottle of conditioner, $6.97, so that'll come out to like $14, right? Then they give you buy 2 and value save for $13.47. What exactly are we saving here? 50 cents? 50? What? Hands up high.
feels basic. You live life on an everyday basis with poetic justice. Poetic justice. If I told you that a flower would bloom in a dark room, would you trust it? I mean, I write poems in these songs dedicated to you and you're in the mood for empathy. Just blood in my pen. Better yet, with your friends and them. I really wanna know you all. I really wanna show you off. Fuck God, pour up plenty of champagne. Cold nights when you curse this name. You called up your girlfriends and y'all curled in that little bitty range. I heard that she wanna go and party. She wanna go and party. Nigga, don't approach your
way. On my way to go do Destiny's hair for her baby shower tomorrow. And I did CJ's hair. It came out really nice. We wanted to try a new style. His birthday coming up. And he was showing me how to cut his hair, and he told me he gonna let me cut it, which we just gonna have to wait and see. I know he gonna let me do it, but I'm just a little bit nervous. But literally prior to me going to hair school, I was trying to decide if I wanted to do barber, if I wanted to go to barber school, or if I wanted to go to cosmetology. I ended up just going to cosmetology because I felt like I could learn more and I can go, you know, in different ways, different avenues. But I still want to learn how to cut hair, or at least how to like line people up. Especially with me doing locks, I feel like I could, you know, do a retwist or do some barrel twist or whatever. And then, you know, Charlie's about to grab me some Starbucks, go do her hair. And CJ wanted to go out later on for his birthday. I'm just trying to see what they talking about, because y'all know me, I'd be right in the bed. But we'll see.
Nigga matcha.
I didn't make it back in last night until like 2 in the morning. They were still getting ready for the baby shower and everything. So in between like us eating, me doing her hair and everything, I probably got done with her hair around like 11:30, and then it was raining like super super hard. So I was trying to just chill until the rain stopped, but the rain was not stopping, and I hate driving in the rain. So right, today is the baby shower. The baby shower not till 4, and like I said, all the outfits I had planned for this weekend were literally like back out, legs out, because you know it's summer and it been real hot, but this Michigan weather switch on you. So it was pouring all last night. Today, I think it's a little warm, but it's still just wet. So obviously the outfit I had planned, I had like a little romper, but like my back was out, my front was out, arms, legs, everything was pretty much out. I'm not gonna be able to wear that. I'm about to head to the mall. So hopefully when I go to the mall, I find something, fingers crossed. If not, I'm about to have to just pull something up out that closet. But yeah, I'm getting ready now because like I said, I didn't get home till like 2:30. I didn't actually go to sleep until like 4 something. So when we decided we were going to go to the mall, it was damn near 5 o'clock in the morning. And we were just going to go when they first opened up at 11 because it's Sunday, but it's 11 o'clock right now. So hopefully we make it by 12.
But one thing Charlie's not going to do is disappoint. Most definitely. Not going to disappoint.
Lighting here is terrible. I'm running a bit late, but I just put on this half top, this tan bag, and these tan leggings. The outfit is very cute. I did like some concealer under my eyes and then my eyebrows. So it's not really no makeup, but it is makeup, whatever, but it looks cute. The hair is just flowing. I'm running a bit late and I still gotta stop at the store, so I'm just about to hurry up and leave now.
Keep running circles around the snail hole.
My name is Kodak Babylon. You see me? Ted Baker. Not that one, that's a soccer ball. The other one, the red one behind you.
I can't see it.
It's right there in your face, Amari.
I can't.
Amari.
What? What? I can't see it.
Right there, you standing next to it. It's just about as big as you. Turn around, turn around. All right, yeah, you playing.
I can't see it.
I'm gonna get up out your room. What you playing?
I can't see it. I can't see it.